Hello everyone! In this video I will give an introduction of circuits, how the challenges are displayed and how to complete challenge 1 in Short Circuit VR. But first of all, what is Short Circuit VR? Basically, it's an electronics lab simulator in virtual reality where you can build electronic circuits with the components in the game, learn some basics by completing challenges. We currently have 9 challenges available, and just try to create things and experiment in the game. We are just 2 graduates working on this project, so this version is still a very early version or alpha version. We want to add so many more features, but before we do that, we'd like to know what other people think of it, of course, and if people would like to play something like this. You can download it for free on Steam, so definitely try it out if you're interested and let us know what you think. If you only want to see the solution of challenge 1, or a specific part of the tutorial, you can check the timestamps in the description below. If you are a beginner, make sure to go on our website shortcircuitvr.com, check out the challenges page and read the information that can help you complete the challenge. If you toggle the tab on the bottom, you can see a possible solution, so make sure to check it out yourself. Okay, so now I'm in the garage of the game, but before I begin, I'll set the height of the table in front of us so I can sit on my lazy butt while building the circuit. To teleport, press the blue circle on your touchpad and release it to the place where you'd like to move. You can slide this yellow thing here to adjust the height of the table. Press the off button if you don't want to accidentally push the teleport button. You can always enable it back by pressing the on button next to it. To access the challenges, press the yellow menu button above the touchpad to open the menu. Here you can find all sorts of features, but for now we'll need the challenge menu. You can select the challenge you want by rotating your finger on the touchpad, so I'll select challenge 1. After you've selected, text will appear on the table mat and a show solution lever will appear. Every challenge has a challenge description, a circuit diagram, and most of the time extra information that can potentially help you solve the challenge. In the description, it says connect a resistor to the battery so that you get a closed circuit. This is one of the most simple circuits that you can build. Before I start building the circuit, I'll give an introduction of electronics so that you understand what I will be doing later on. Electricity or electric current is a movement of small electrically charged particles in the same direction. These particles are also known as electrons, and most of the time they go through a conductor. Conductors are materials, and commonly metals, where electricity can flow through. So it's basically a path to transport electrons from one side of the conductor to the other. For example, the pins of this LED. You can use jumper wires or wires that are already attached to an electronic component. To make the electrons start moving through the wires, you need a power source. A power source is a source of electrical energy, such as a battery or electric generator. You need a power source to push the electrons through the conductors. Once the electrons arrive at the electronic component, the transported energy will be absorbed by the electronic component, and the energy will be used to turn it into another form of energy, such as light in a light bulb. An electric circuit needs at least 3 basic things to make sure that electric current can flow through it. First thing is a power source. You need a power source to move the electrons through the circuit. Second thing is an electrical load. The load is something that absorbs electrical energy in a circuit. For instance, the light bulb, something that will use that energy to do something. And the last thing is a conductive path so that electrons can flow between the source and the load. We will mostly be using jumper wires or pins of electronic components as conductors in Short Circuit VR. Let's take a look at the diagram. The symbol at the bottom stands for a power source, or in this case a battery. In the extra information section, you can see that there is a plus sign at the longest line and a minus at the short line. This means that the long line represents the positive side of the battery and a short line the negative side. The rectangle at the top is an international symbol for a resistor. Sometimes you'll also see zigzag lines, and that's just another symbol for the resistor. Between the source and the resistor, you have lines at both sides. These lines act as the conductive path that lets electrons flow in the circuit. I'll be using jumper wires to connect the battery with the resistor. There's already a breadboard spawned with a battery connected. Press one of the grip buttons on the controller to grab an object in the game. A breadboard is a small plastic board with a lot of holes, also called terminals, into which you can push components or wires. Under the surface of the breadboard are metal strips that act as conductors, and these connect groups of holes internally. The reason why you would use a breadboard is to connect components and wires more organized without having to solder the components together first. Well, in this game, every component can snap easily together, but when you use real components, it's not that easy without soldering. So that's why it's better to use a breadboard if you're experimenting and just trying things out. You can still take out the components and reuse it for other circuits. The breadboard used in Short Circuit VR has two horizontal strips of terminals at the top and at the bottom as well. Each terminal in a horizontal strip is internally connected with the other terminals in that strip. Besides the horizontal strips, you've got two blocks of 30 vertical strips with 5 terminals in each strip. Again, each terminal in a vertical strip is connected to the other terminals in that strip. On the image, the green lines on the breadboard are the internal connections. So for example, the terminal to the right of the blue terminal is not internally connected because it's not in the same strip. This one is also not internally connected to the blue one because there is a separation in the middle of the breadboard. However, this other blue terminal is internally connected. To connect with other terminals outside the vertical strip, you need conductors such as wires or pins from electronic components. Usually, the battery or another power source is connected to the horizontal strips. You can put other electronic components in the vertical strips and then make connections between the components and power source using jumper wires. What is a resistor? A resistor is a passive electronic component that can be used to restrict the flow of electric current. Resistors come in many different values, and you can read the values by looking at the color bands on the resistors. The higher the value, the more it will restrict the current. The resistance is measured in ohm, written with this symbol. Keep in mind that the circuit in Challenge 1 is pretty useless, but we use it as an example to give a basic understanding of how current works in a circuit. Okay, now we can finally start building our first circuit. Now I'll spawn a resistor from the menu. Go to the Components menu, go to Resistors. Here you can choose from many different values, but for the first challenge, we will need a resistor with a high enough value to restrict the current. So I spawn a 1000 ohm resistor and place it somewhere in the vertical strips. The power source is already connected to the breadboard, so I don't need to do that anymore. Now that you have the source and the load, the only thing you need to do is to create a conductive path for the electrons to travel and let the current flow. In other words, connect the load to the power source by using wires. Using red wires for positive terminals and black wires for negative terminals is a common way to connect a power source in electronics, so I'll just follow this convention. Okay, everything is connected, and now we should test out the circuit. To do this in Short Circuit VR, you need to go to Play Mode. Press the Play button in the menu and the current will start flowing. Now you can see on the table mat that the challenge is completed. Now, if you hover over your components, you'll get pop-ups with information about that specific component. On the battery, it says that it has 9 volts. You can see how much resistance this resistor has, and how much current flows through the resistor. The electrons are now flowing through the circuit, and this can only happen in a closed circuit. You get a closed circuit when all the components are connected and there's no break or hole in your circuit. So when I pull one end of the wire out, for example, It will create a break in the circuit. This way, electrons are not able to reach other components or the power source, and as a result, the electric current stops flowing. This is called an open circuit, and you don't want that, so make sure the circuit has no gaps in it. Just now I said that we need to have a closed circuit to let the current flow, but when you connect the two terminals of a power source directly to each other, then there is no break in it either. However, you should never connect it like this, because it will cause too much current in the circuit and may end up breaking or burning something. This is called a short circuit, and you have to avoid it at all times. So how do you avoid a short circuit? You avoid it by adding a resistor to the circuit, because a resistor can restrict the flow of the current. This is why the circuit of this challenge consists of a resistor and a power source, and not only a power source. The symbol at the bottom is the battery. The symbol at the top is a resistor, and the two lines at the sides are the wires connected. Now, if you teleport to your right near the lever, you can pull the lever and a possible solution will appear. You can only grab the breadboard of this example, and you can't take out the components. Short circuit VR is definitely not made to replace real components. We hope that the things you can learn in the game can also be used with real components. Here I have a breadboard, a 9-volt battery, a red and a brown wire, and a resistor with a value of 1000 ohm. Place a resistor somewhere around the vertical strips to make things easier. Place the brown wire to the strip that is connected to the right end of the resistor. It doesn't matter which hole or terminal, as long as it's in the same strip. Place the red wire in the same strip as the left end of the resistor, and connect the other end to the horizontal line with the plus sign. Lastly, connect the battery. It's best to connect the power source after everything else is connected safely. Take the red wire and place it in the plus horizontal strip, and a black wire in a minus horizontal strip. Now, electric current is flowing through the circuit. Okay, that's it for now. I am in no way a professional teacher or an electronics expert, so let us know in the comments how we could improve, and any feedback is welcome. This video is mostly made to show people what you can do in short circuit VR and learn things in virtual reality. If you like this game or video, give it a thumbs up and share it with as many people as you can. For the people who can't try the game out themselves, go to our website and you can fill in our Google Forms to share your feedback. We really hope that people can learn more about electronics from this game and that we can continue working on this project. This is why we want to share it with as many people as we can, but most importantly, see if there actually are people who like the concept of our game. If you want to keep up with our progress or updates, follow us on Facebook, on Twitter with the hashtag ShortCircuitVR, and we have our own subreddit where you can ask questions and share your opinion. Thank you for watching and have an amazing day!